Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to the First Presbyterian Church in Barrie. We start our service, every service, by acknowledging that our church and many of our homes are located on the unceded and ancestral land of the Abenaki people. We acknowledge that they are still here, continuing to honor and bring light to their heritage, and that we benefit every day from the theft of their land.
Thank you.
again. So, in case you haven't noticed, in our bulletin, we list all the birthdays of the month. And on the very top of that list is a very special person's name. It's Joseph, who is turning 7 years old today. So let's wish Joseph a happy birthday by singing to him. Dan, could you help? Joseph, we hope you have a very special and happy day. Okay, so here we are, November 6th, and I'm happy to welcome once again Reverend Carol Ann Barker from the Northeast Kingdom. It's always a pleasure to have you here leading us in worship, so thank you for joining us. Also, this is a special service today in that we're going to take a moment to remember those who passed on. We're calling it Moment of Memories. So now would be a good time if you brought a photograph, or if you didn't have a photograph but want to write someone's name on a piece of paper and bring it up and just put it on the piano and refer to those photographs and names later in the service. So thank you for that. And so again, so this is November 6th. We turn the clocks back. And this is, I have to confess that November is not my favorite month. In fact, it's probably my least favorite month. You know, we've had the pleasure of summer and the beauty of the fall. And I do love being in a place that has four seasons. Well, actually five if you count mud season. But I really don't enjoy the transitions. And it made me think this morning when I was thinking the transition of November and how I need to try to get a better mindset of that. It reminded me that, yes, we too, our congregation, is going through a transition. And so, once again, here we are, hoping, looking forward to a new beginning, a new season in our congregation, and we look forward to that happening in the near future. So, with that, please join me in the call to worship. Mm-hmm. The earth is the Lord's and all that is in it, the world and those who live in it.
For he has founded it on the seas and established it on the rivers.
Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord, and who shall stand in his holy place?
Those who have clean hands and pure hearts, who do not lift up their souls to what is false, and do not swear deceitfully.
They will receive blessing from the Lord and vindication from the God of our salvation.
Such is the company of those who seek Him, who seek the face of the God of Jacob.
Okay, and please join me in the opening hymn, number 371, Now Songs of Celebration Render.
Thank you. You may be seated. Let us now continue truly this time of thanksgiving and praise as we confess before God the ways in which we are less than perfect. And yet he calls us to him and he calls us to be thankful. Let us pray together the prayer that is printed in the bulletin. Almighty God, in love you spread good gifts before us, more than we need or deserve. You feed, heal, teach, and save us. We confess that we always want more, that we never share as freely as you give. We resent what we lack and are jealous of labors. We misuse what you intend for joy. God, forgive our stubborn greed and our destructiveness. In mercy, help us to take such pleasure in your goodness that we will always be thanking you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As God's own people, let us be merciful in action, kind in heart, humble in mind. Let us always be ready to forgive as freely as the Lord has forgiven us. And above everything else, let us be loving and never forget to be thankful for what God has done for us. Thanks be to God. God sent into the world his only Son. Since God loved us so much, we too should love one another. Let us love one another, since love comes from God. The peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us now share our signs of the peace during the time in which we're living.
Please join me in the prayer for illumination. Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word is proclaimed, we may hear with joy what you say to us today. Amen. The first reading today comes from Matthew, chapter 5, 1 through 12a. I think it'll be familiar. It's the Beatitudes. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs will be the kingdom in heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward in heaven is great, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were there before you." This is the word of the Lord.
Today, change of plan. Not really, it was planned, but the next two passages, Jonah and Habakkuk, I've included adequately within the prompting, so I've decided to not read them ahead of the prompting time. But the references are there in case you want to check in with them either now or later this afternoon or another time when you're reflecting on what we've shared today. Today we celebrate All Saints Sunday and honor those saints who have lived among us and have now gone to their heavenly home, as well as those who are among the communion of saints here on earth. Later on the service, we will be recognizing those who have died during the past year, and I'd like to say any of our saint loved ones who we remember deep in our heart, certainly each day, but we will in a special way recognize and remember and be saying a special prayer today. And as I begin, when I just think of everything that so many of you are involved in with the preparation of worship each Sunday, and then everything else that also goes on unseen or perhaps unspoken that you do during this transition time throughout the week, I just want to say I honor you and I recognize just what saints you are right here in Barrie, in this church, in this community. Yesterday afternoon, I was doing a funeral for a person up in Derby Line, right on the Canadian border. I mean, within sight of the customs as you go back and forth. And the son and daughter-in-law of one of the, well, of the woman who passed away from Hardwick. And I said, "Oh," I said, "I'll be coming down through Hardwick tomorrow because I get to go to Barrie." And anyway, it turns out she knew Carl and she's somehow in charge of, she works at the food pantry here. Her name is Barb Jenny. Anyway, it's just, you know, the connections among the saints throughout the Northeast Kingdom and beyond, it just is very precious to me. And just on a, again, you folks, you make me laugh. We worship together. I look forward to worshiping. The music blesses. I mean, it's wonderful to come down here. And so I just wanted to make a comment on our photo today, which Dottie chose. And she said, she says, "Those really are ornery saints that you chose for the sermon today. And she said, so I tried to find a picture of two ornery men. So again, if you want to decide who is Habakkuk and who is Jonah, which one might be the more ornery, we'll process that as we go through the sermon today too. So there is a huge variety of saints, as each one of us can consider ourselves and those we know and love. God's friends are as diverse as his creativity. Man or woman, young child, or someone who lived 100 years. One who lived alone in the desert, or one who has raised a large family. A talented musician, laborer, entrepreneur, or someone who never has left their sick bed. One who seemed to follow a straight path, or one who tried every form of sin before finding her true purpose. So the first saint we're going to take a look at today is Jonah. Yes, the very same Jonah who was swallowed by a large fish and refused to do what God called him to do, which was go to Nineveh, tell the people of God's mercy and God's love. Instead, Jonah fled in the opposite direction, away from Nineveh, any place but Nineveh. And why? This is where we can begin to be able to identify with Jonah, because it turns out that the people from Nineveh were enemies of Jonah, and his family, his people. Why, Jonah wondered, should he have to tell them about God's love and forgiveness? And so to put it just in a bit of a contemporary context, some of us up in Derby have begun to connect with Ukrainian parents, young people, and children who live at the Agape Mercy House in Derby, right across from the Derby Community Church where Fred and I served for 20 years. These Ukrainians are wonderful, loving people, and it's absolutely mind-boggling to me to even imagine what they have suffered before arriving here. Along with our grandchildren and others from the area, these families are part of a homeschool co-op at the church each Friday afternoon, where there are crafts, watercoloring, ballet lessons, a writing workshop that our son is leading, soccer, all sorts of fun. But what if God were to call us or our new Ukrainian friends to go back to the people who put them in the situation of having to flee from home and come here? Is God really asking us to share his love and mercy with the same people who have killed family and friends of our Ukrainian friends? What if God would want us to share his love with the enemy? And Jonah didn't much like that assignment from God. Worst of all, according to Jonah, by the time we even get to chapter 4, which is what we will be dealing with from the Bible in Jonah today, the people of Nineveh had believed Jonah's message of love, these are the enemies, and repented, even their animals wearing sackcloth. How do we feel when the enemy decides, oh wow, it's time to forgive, it's time to be forgiven? So Jonah became angry, really angry, defending himself, saying to God, that is why I left Tarshish at the first place, for I knew that you are a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and ready to relent from punishing. In other words, God, that's not fair. That's just too much. And I think if anybody if any of us wants to put it in an even more personal context, you know, if someone in our family has been murdered or died at the hand of another, in whatever way, you know, how do we process that whole forgiveness aspect of things? Robert Frost, the poet, certainly had a view on it. And he said, after Jonah, you could never trust God not to be merciful again. So again, I think when I'm honest about it, I've got more of the Robert Frost in me with regards to the that's not fair syndrome. How can we trust God to deal with our enemies if we are to love our enemies? I mean, it's right in the Bible, but again, when we get to real situations, real people, it's tough, and Jonah expresses that. He's angry enough that he wants to die. But God takes time for this wayward child, this saint even. And he continues the conversation by asking Jonah, and this is all right through chapter 4, if it is right for him to be angry. And with a little emphasis on, you know, isn't it right, God, for me to be angry? So then God provides a bush for Jonah's comfort because he's in the hot sun at this point. The next morning, God also provides a worm who attacks the bush, and the bush dies. And so when the sun comes up, God prepares the sultry east wind, reminding Jonah that although Jonah is concerned about the bush, which he did nothing to create or help grow, should not God be able to choose to care about the people of Nineveh? And the beautiful thing about what God does with this saint, and I think which makes it so contemporary for us, is that God leaves Jonah and us with this question at the end of the book. He doesn't tell us the answer. He brings out very clearly, though, is it okay for God to be God? Do we trust him to run the universe? And you know, sometimes at the end of the day, and I'm stressing out and not ready to fall asleep, and Fred will say to me, he says, do you think God can run the universe for the night, maybe? So, you know, I relate to this Jonah. Is it up to us to put limits on God's mercy and forgiveness? Jonah's name itself means beloved. Jonah and each one of us is God's beloved. Each one of us right now is going through our own personal challenges and struggles. Some more public than others, some maybe are just between us and God. God knows our doubts and our questions and walks through each one with each one of us. And he did this with Jonah as well, and we just see a vintage picture of what this looks like in what has been recorded in this book. It is good to know, at least for me, that on this All Saints Sunday, that there is a saint named Jonah, beloved, who questions God, and we can see is still very much loved by God. It is okay to be Jonah. We can feel safe with God as we seek to grow in our own sainthood, our own sanctification, not all at once, not without setbacks, but still journeying on the plan that he has for us. Kathy shared earlier Jesus' teaching from Matthew chapter 5, the Beatitudes. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. This is how Jesus lived. This is how Jesus calls us to live. We may be a bit unruly or cantankerous or ornery, whatever word we can fill in the blank with, but we are on our way, and we can trust that. All Saints Day also gives us an opportunity to remember and be thankful for the saints who have been part of our own lives personally. For me, I'm thankful for the Sunday school teacher who brought alive to me the courage of Abraham and Sarah to leave home and follow God to a distant land. Or another saint in the making, a busy mom of teens who's a customer service person in a local grocery store and made and gave me my first mask during the pandemic. You can each, I know, think of many saints who have helped you to be where you are, doing what you are doing right here today. As we move toward the celebration of Thanksgiving, I think of another saint. The prophet Habakkuk begins the book named after him with a complaint. He saw injustice, violence, and evil in his own country. We can relate to that. Yet God remained silent and invisible. Why didn't God intervene? Why did God give no answer when Habakkuk called out for help? Habakkuk took these questions directly to God in prayer. And God answered Habakkuk, but hardly in the way he had anticipated. For God let him know that he was sending the Babylonians to punish Judah. God's words described a ruthless, savage army that would tear Israel apart. And so, he didn't give up. Habakkuk complained again. Could this be justice, punishing Judah through an even more evil nation? Deeply perplexed, Habakkuk waited to see what answer would come to his second complaint. How long Habakkuk had to wait exactly, we don't know. But ultimately, it wasn't God who changed his mind, but gave Habakkuk the gift of grace to be strengthened in his faith as things were. The book that begins with a complaint concludes with one of the most beautiful songs in the Bible of trust and joy in the midst of trouble. These are the words from the prophet himself. Though the fig tree does not blossom, and no fruit is on the vines, and the fields yield no food, though the flock is cut off from the fold, and there is no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will exalt in the God of my salvation. God, the Lord, is my strength and makes my feet like the feet of a deer and makes me tread upon the heights. Beautiful, deep faith, and yet not easy words to hear, but so powerful in their trust and thanksgiving. Habakkuk was a saint who dared to question God, and through his questions was strengthened in faith. We, all of us, are an unlikely bunch of saints. Yet each of us is created in the image of God, and therefore we each have God's imprint on us, as do our enemies. And so as we are open to God's presence in ourselves and others, let us continue loving God, loving neighbors. And again, ordinary as it may seem as far as what our day-to-day life looks like, that's what grows us into the saint that God has called us to be. Amen. Let us now turn to our hymn, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling.
These cranes were made lovingly by Leora Romito, on whose land we worship most of the time during the summer. And she's not here today, but Leora deserves an awful lot of credit for an awful lot of work. Each one of these cranes represents a member of our family, who was a member of our church, the names are on there, going back to 1889 when the church was founded. This was done for, Leora made these for our celebration of our 125th birthday of the church, which I believe was in 2014. Her hands were busy for several months beforehand. And I would have to say that when I walked up here Thursday, Joe Ford, Sally, and I were downstairs doing music, and we heard some stuff going on upstairs. And I came upstairs, and Barbara Natchi and her husband, John Killian, had cranes all, I mean, you know, they were all over the place. You kind of had to be careful where you step. So, but they made order out of this, and by the end of the afternoon, the decorations as you see them are what was happening. So this was a wonderful memorial, a gift from Leora, all of these cranes that represent all the membership of this church from years back, all the saints that have gone before us. So just keep that in mind as we proceed to the rest of the service. Oh, I see some of them here, you know, they're just, yeah, I think they're reproducing as we go. But today we are honoring all of the saints in our own personal lives. People have brought some pictures in, and if you brought a picture in, please come up, take your picture, and tell us who it is. And if there are any of you that have a special person in mind, a relative or a friend, and you don't have a picture, that's all right. If you want to stand and mention the name of your special person, we will light a candle for them also. So first, if anybody has any more pictures to bring up, please do so right now, and we will light a candle. And Sylvia.
Thank you. my mother and father, Jim and Lou Passon.
So, thank you. Lydia is holding up a picture of her parents. Thank you all for sharing.
I have two girls. I'm going to, okay. But oh no, if there's anybody else, then I might as well go into the prayer after that if everyone else has.
Thank you all for sharing. Those of you that have not shared anything, if you have any people or special people that are in your hearts and minds, God cares about that also. God knows.
Amen. Jordan Carpenter, who died just a month ago, he was only 20 years old, in a motorcycle accident. And a dear friend of mine also, Penny Wheeler, who passed away this summer with cancer. Too young, she was only 56. But one of the things I think of today is that she can't be here with her grandchildren, but she's a saint with Jordan, and she can be a mom in heaven now. So thank you, everybody, for your sharing. And now let us pray. Almighty God, you created us for life together as the communion of saints on earth and in heaven. We give thanks for each of our loved ones who have gone to be with you during this year and in times past. Those named here today and those we name in our hearts. We thank you for all they have been to our lives, for the memories and the inspiration they continue to be in our lives. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend these, your servants. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, each sheep of your own fold, each lamb of your own flock, each son and daughter of your own redeeming. Receive them into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. O God, strengthen us in love so that we may serve you as a faithful people and live together in your joy through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
We have time for announcements. As mentioned in the e-newsletter, we are getting one step closer to having an interim pastor. It's not a done deal yet, but we have interviewed someone who we believe will fit the congregation well, and we're in the process of moving that along. So more to come in the near future on that. Today, there will be a coffee hour downstairs to continue what we started last week as far as identifying, I don't know, Diane, if you want to say more, but to continue identifying the groups that we want to have in times that we want to start the discussion of our mission study.
I have a couple of announcements.
Okay. Now would be a good time then. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So just a couple of quick announcements. One, yes, and I forgot a lot of sticky notes, so feel free to use the sticky notes that are present down there to answer the questions of what has been some impacts on our finances in the history and what we can anticipate or be thinking about as we do our stewardship journey together. There's also a link in the e-note, and you can also feel free to email me any thoughts as well. And please do sign up for some small group work that we will then reach out and get going for you as well. We had a wonderful scone making yesterday, went very quickly, and we're 13 days away from the big event. So there are sign-up sheets in the back. Lots of our saints who have gone before us are prodding us forward and reminding us of that beautiful history that we have. And so please take a minute to sign up. We do the Thanksgiving baskets. I had a little extra help from a few other people that kind of changed up the order, but that's okay. So today is all about the pumpkin pie. And so many people brought the fixings with the spices and the evaporated milk. The pastry part I had set aside for next week, but that's okay. The word got out that what are you gonna put the pie filling in if you don't have the pastry, so that's there today. And next week, so I took liberty of planning a meal of what I would want, evidently, and I left off the cranberries. So next week we will have it be cranberries. So I don't know how you want to bring your cranberries in, but just bring in cranberries and we'll go from there. So there are remaining amounts that we do need that if you think you're going to be able to bring this, please let me know so we don't have extras of all kinds of things. So in terms of the mixed vegetables that we're going to give, we have cans of corn, cans of green beans, and cans of carrots. And so in order to complete the baskets, we need 6 more cans of corn and 11 more cans of carrots. We only need 1 more stuffing and then 4 more boxes of potatoes. So I will make sure if you can't remember because of I told you quickly, then just email me and I'll let you know what the things are. And again, a reminder that next week is, what is it? There you go. All right.
Any other announcements?
Thank you.
And now we have a time to offer prayers. Are there any prayers that people would like to offer? Peg?
Prayers of gratitude for all the people that have worked so hard to keep the church going. And we mention it once in a while, but it's with us so often that there's an awful lot of time and prayer and thought that is going into the decisions that are being made. So prayers of gratitude for all those hard workers. Mm-hmm. Prayers of gratitude also for the work that Lee Harvey did on the cranes and for Barbara and John giving their time to decorating the church. Mm-hmm. And special thanks also to Rebecca Muller, Dan's wife, who is here helping us out this morning and sharing her talent.
Right, so gratitude for all of those helping to make the congregation and our service work well, and especially to Rebecca for sharing her talents today. Pam?
Gratitude for the great turnout for stone making yesterday. It was a fun working.
Yeah. So gratitude toward the great turnout for making scones. It was a lot of fun in the kitchen yesterday. Mm-hmm. Each week we offer prayers for members of our congregation. This week we are keeping Ellen Light and her family in our prayers. Gracious Lord, we give thanks for them. And in their presence in the congregation, hold them in the palm of your hand and let them feel your love. Give them the wisdom and the strength to do your will and the faith and the courage to face whatever challenges may arise. We also pray for members of our PNNE, and this week we ask to keep the Presbyterian participants in your thoughts and prayers, focusing on the military chaplains this week. Josh? Okay, so that's the Lorenza family who lost a member?
I-O-R-N-D-A.
Okay, if you can pass that along, that would be great. Pray for that family who lost a member. Any other prayers? Reverend Barker?
Let us pray. Gracious God, hear each prayer that has been spoken. We pray for those who have lost loved ones, including the Lorenza family. We pray for military chaplains, for all in the military. We pray for veterans as we come upon the celebration of Veterans Day this week. We thank you for each person who is, really includes everyone here and even those who cannot be here, for taking part in worship and in enabling things to go smoothly and with beauty, with thanksgiving. We thank you for each one of the saints in this church who is part of what is going on right now, the transition toward the interim pastor. We pray for that person, whoever is called. We know that you are choosing the right one for this time, for this place. We pray for our country, pray for our president and for all other leaders. We pray for our election on Tuesday. Lord, be with each one of us. Be with each one of these leaders. And Lord, we pray that your will be done and that we are open to your call to each one of us during this time in our lives. We pray for peace. There is so much noise out there in the world, so much noise within our own lives. And so we thank you for this time of worship, and we pray for your peace that truly does pass all understanding. We pray for our enemies, and Lord, we know that you call us to love each other. And so remove the hate and the prejudice from our own hearts. And we pray that your children, each one of us, may be reconciled with those we fear, those we resent, those that we may threaten, so that we may live together in peace. And Lord, give us hope. Give us the vision to live out your way throughout the world with goodwill and justice, that our leaders may be supportive of taking down barriers and drawing us together as one people. And pray for the work that each one of us does. Manage us, wise God, by your Spirit, so that the work that we do serves your purpose. And each one of us does our part to make this world a good home for all your children. Merciful God, you bear the hurt of the world. Look with compassion on those who are sick. Cheer them by your word. And Lord, bring health as a sign that in your promised kingdom, there will be no more pain or crying. God of comfort, stand with those in sorrow, that they may be sure that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come shall separate them from your love through Jesus Christ. Bless our friends and families, all those whom we love, whether they're near or far away physically, and draw each one close to you, and draw us closer to each other. And we pray for all your servants who have been faithful to you on earth and now live in heaven. Keep us in fellowship with them until we meet again. And may we experience a taste of the joy of your kingdom even now. Almighty God, whose word we trust, whose Spirit prays in our prayers, sort out our requests and further those which are helpful. and will bring about your purposes on earth. Through Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Mighty God, good Father, we thank you for the gift of life and for the world our home. We thank you for your loving kindness to us and to all people. Your works are great and wonderful. Your ways are just and true. You alone are holy. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God, the Almighty. He was, he is to come. Holy God, we praise you for your Son Jesus, who shared our weakness and was tempted in every way as we are, who obeyed you by suffering and dying for us. You have raised him to rule the world and given him a name above every name, Lord in Christ. We praise you and we glorify you. Great God, our Father. Now give us your spirit in the breaking of bread, so that by your power we may be drawn together and made one through Jesus Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life. With Christians through all ages, we lift our hearts to you, giving thanks and trusting you to use us and your people, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night of his arrest, took bread. And after giving thanks, broke and said, This is my body, broken for you. Do this in memory of me. In the same way, Jesus took the cup after supper. And said, this is the blood of the new covenant sealed in my blood. Whenever you drink it, do this, remembering me. He who believes in me will never thirst. Come for all his name. Jesus says, I am the vine, you are the branches. Abide in me, and I in you, and you will bear much fruit. Take and drink. Let us pray. We thank you, God, for this supper shared in the spirit of your Son, Jesus, who makes us new and strong and brings us life eternal. We praise you for giving all good gifts in him and pledge ourselves to serve you even as you have served us in Jesus Christ. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Anyone who follows me will not be walking in the dark, but will have the light of life. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. The closing hymn is For All the Saints, number 326.
Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Have no anxiety about anything, but in everything, by prayer and thanksgiving, with joy, may your hearts and your lives experience the peace that passes all understanding. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.